dancers, today we are going to go over the combination that I have taught both in DanceAbility and my adult jazz funk pop classes, and it is to Jean-Baptiste Freedom. So it's very much got a funk element to it, it's got a bit of a Motown element to it, and we've got a lot of work with the upper body as well as the lower body. And if you are aware of any of our DanceAbility routines, we've got a lot of upper body because these routines are choreographed specifically to be done either full bodied, with assistance, or in a seated position. So the way that I'm going to teach this one today, because it's got a lot of details to it. I'm going to start with lower body first, upper body second, and then we're going to put the two together. So just the lower body, we are doing our apple jacks, and one, and two, and three, and four. You probably notice I'm going to the 2 o'clock from a diagonal. I then do a pas de bourrée with my right and my left. It's very percussive. Five and six with a little bit of a pulse. Seven and eight. That eight is like you're prepping yourself in a position, a stance to be solid, because we're then going to roll to our toes and do a knee pop. One, two. We're going to circle our knees in a counterclockwise or anti-clockwise fashion, right all the way around the left. As we come back, you see my hips are starting to pitch back, which means I'm going to go onto my heels and lift up my toes, coming on down, five, six, and then I'm going to lunge out to the 2 o'clock position, seven and eight. Then I'm going to go ahead and do a Charleston-esque type of lunge, one, two. With my right foot, I'm going to cross over, three, I'm going to align four. And I'm facing somewhere around my 4 or 5 o'clock position here with a nice broad stance. Because as I go into this next move, you're going to have options. You can either do a full hinge down to touch the floor and come back up again. You can do a partial hinge, whatever level you feel comfortable with. It can be a bend in the knees, making sure that the abdominals are lifted and the hips are tucked under. And you can decide how well you feel on the day. If you want to lift up your heels and do a force arch fully out of the ball of the foot, or if you simply want to keep the heels down and hinge into it with your knees only. But we'll add arms to that in a moment. So we go back 5, 6, we come up 7, 8. We do a shorty George. You could even do a boogie walk if you wanted, but we do those later, so I like to keep this a little more shorty George with our right foot. One, two, three, four, and that's headed to our 2 o'clock. You then push back off of your left to your right, 5, 6, 7, 8, noticing that I'm dragging, squeezing in on my thighs, and lifting that toe to keep it a little bit more funky or Motown-esque. I transfer my weight on one, and then I jump right, left, or thread the needle, and two. You'll see later we do the head on three. Four, we unwind, 5, 6, we'll do an upper body on, and 7, 8, we'll transfer our weight from our left to, from our right to our left, stretching that back foot, one, walk two, walk three, walk four, turn back and look over your shoulder, 5, 6, walk right, left, 7, 8. Now this next bit I've left for you to interpret artistically, whether it's something you hear in the music or whether it's just what you feel up to timing-wise, rhythm-wise, or ability-wise. We're doing top rocks next. So you have the ability to take two top rocks, normal tempo, to rotate to the 12 o'clock. Or you can take four double time to rotate that same distance. So the regular speed would be one and two and three and four and. The double time would be one and two, three and four, five and six, seven, eight. Now that first one, let me recount because I realized I didn't and since the numbers. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight versus one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. So once we get back to this position, seven and eight, and we're gonna lunge to the right, drop, drop, come up, we'll clap, drop, drop, come up, we'll clap. We'll then, as he lifts his voice in the octave in the song, hit our heels, one and two and three and four.
is a tap. You could do the heel and bring it back if you feel you have enough time. He raises his voice again for kangaroo, and we do a little hitch kick underneath ourselves, 5 and 6. So notice how I hitch kick, but I land on the ball of my foot, so I'm in releve, 5 and 6. And then I charge the audience with my left foot, 7 and 8. Then I step out with my left foot to the diagonal, about the 11 o'clock, 1, and I do it with a flat foot and straight knees, and I pull in 2, 3, 4, and then I do 2 halftime boogie walks forward, 5, 6, 7, 8. So I will back that up a little bit and say everything up until this point has been initiated on the right side first, but at this point in time, it's now going to be left. So from the hitch kick to the charge, all the way through the rest of this, is all gonna initiate with the left foot first. So we've just boogie walked 5, 6, 7, 8. We go into what I call the orangutan, where we lunge left and right and chasse to the left, right and left and chasse to the right. We then do a grind, heel grind, 1 and 2, 3 and 4. We do our scissors and 5 and 6 and 7 and 8. At this point in time, we go ahead and freestyle for the next major phrase. So that's lower body, let's work on upper body. So we've got our right hand on our hats, because we use a hat for this routine. I should have worn it today for this video, but it can be any type of hat that has a brim. If it's a baseball cap, you're working with the narrow brim. If you've got like a little fedora type of full brim, you get to work from ear to ear, which is awesome as well. So we have right hand on the hat brim, left hand across the body. We prepare our right shoulder up, and we do right and left and right and left. Right, left, right, left, right, left, right. Then with our arms, we have our elbows, fingers, elbows, thighs. So we'll try that 5 and 6, 7 and 8 is the way we do it with the actual movement. That is with the pas de grace. And then when we do our toe stand with our knees forward, we thrust the arms, come back for the body. Then they leave the circle like you're stirring a pot. And then you're gonna grasp your wrist with your left hand and push those hips back to get the toe lift. And then when we lunge forward to the 2 o'clock position, I'm gonna just reverse this really quick. It's the shoulder, but it's coming through the lats. Like you're trying to press the shoulder blade into the hip bone, and it's the full forearms that are pressed flat. So you're not banging like hammers. It's the full elbow to middle finger as a platform. 7 and 8. The arms for the Charleston are very standard Charleston arms. As we twist and cross our right leg over the left, our right hand, or our hands are on our right, and we twist around to the left. This hinge is gonna start back stroking with the left hand. Your right hand will be up toward the ceiling, and then your right hand will begin the thrust to pull yourself back up again. That actually helps. So we backstroke on the way down and front stroke on the way up. Then as we're rotating, doing our shorty Georges, we do our smear, 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 smear. And then we do our guitar strum, 5, 6, 7, 8. So the right hand is the rotation, the left hand stays down there at the lower diagonal. Then we transfer our weight on 1. When we jump through and 2, our fist is gonna punch right, left. So it's coming down through our armpit, right, left, and 2. And that's as we jump through. The head goes 3, we start to turn 4, and I do add a little shoulder in there on the turn, 5, 6, and 7, both shoulders go back. It's almost like a hinge without bending the knees. And then 8, 1, 2. Now the 1, 2, hands, 2 fingers, go from the right temple to the left temple, and we walk back 2, 3, 4. When you look over your shoulder, left shoulder rolls 5, 6, walk it 7, 8, and those just opposite hands and feet. Then as we do our top rocks, swing opposite hand, however many you wanna do. It could be the 2 at halftime or the 4. And then as we lunge down, we punch, left hand in front, right hand in back, down, down with the double pulse, up and clap, down, down, up and clap. And then we do our backwards jump rope from the routine several times ago, JT, can't stop the feeling. And we do our heel and heel and heel and tap. As we do the hitch kick, he says kangaroo, so we make little kangaroo ears. charge forward, the hands come out from across the body. Charge 7 and 8. As we hit into the 1, our arms go to a low V with spread fingers, jazz hands. Pull in 2, 3, 4, as if you're sucking everything up through a straw. And then keep the arms traditional in your boogie walks, elbows back, arms silhouetting the back of your lower back and bum. 5, 6, 7, 8. Then we do in our orangutan arms, left shoulder, right shoulder, double to the left, right shoulder, left shoulder, double to the right. We then do our twist with our body and our heel grind. So it goes opposing like you're twisting a dish rag. And then when we do our scissors, this is going to be a cross on the way down to a low V, and then retrace your step, cross on the way back to the W. So you start in the W position and cross and heel and cross and heel. And that's when we then break into our freestyle section. So let me go ahead and dance that to the music. We've got 2 8-counts at the very beginning, the intro, to allow us to count down before we start. Here we go. Focus and isolate on the upper body. All right, here we go with music.